But yeah, and you know, it's not just the RMAH, it's also, you know, the battle tag system that Blizzard has snuck past their players, and it's a fine system, you know, in theory, but it's basically them just masking their real ID system. You know, in the end, people will, you know, get a handle, and they will use it across multiple games, and Blizzard will, you know, be able to track that, and Facebook will be able to track that, and they'll allow, you know, those companies to use it for marketing. And, you know, I'm fine with Facebook selling, you know, their information to advertising companies and marketing and whatever, because the site's free. That's how they make their money. I don't even think they have ads on Facebook. I basically never use it, so I couldn't actually tell you. But, yeah. You know, it's totally free, so of course they're going to have to make their money somehow, and they're going to make it that way, and it's incredibly lucrative for them. You know, Google's the same thing. But, again, it's a free service. Nothing Blizzard produces is free. Nothing is free. It's just, you know, gravy on top of everything else. So that just irritates me. Blizzard's just gotten really corporate. I mean, I followed them for, you know, 15 years or so. 12, 15 years. And, you know, I was there with Diablo 1, StarCraft 1. I missed the Dwarf game and the crappy racing game. But, yeah, I've seen most of it. And I saw them when they were independent and, you know, they were bought by Vivendi. Now they have this merger thing with Activision. But it's really, I mean, Vivendi owns them both, so I don't really blame Activision or Kotick. Did I actually do what I was supposed to do? Yeah. And yeah, I don't know, they're just becoming kind of, you know, evil corporation-y. A little too Walmart-y for my taste at this point, because they're very big, they've been very big for a while, and they damn well know that players will still buy their games no matter what. And there's just, I mean, it's like a monopoly, only not. It's a weird situation. So you guys also know, I apologize, this is quite the rant. This could be, you have no idea how much I am restraining myself right now. This could be so much more. But the reason this is also so important is the holy grail of payment models for games at this point is basically give your game away for free, make money through things like microtransactions, cash shops, real money auction house. So the whole industry is watching this right now. Like, this literally is so important. I don't think a lot of people realize. You know, it's, you know, SOPA and PIPA. And if you don't know what those are, S-O-P-A, P-I-P-A, go look it up. Google's your friend. I'm not going to get into that right now, even though that's even more important. But, you know, it's basically of that magnitude as far as the future of gaming is concerned. Not the future of the world, but as much as SOPA and PIPA likes to, people against it like to say, but definitely so important. And, you know, microtransactions, some companies do them very well. I think Valve does a good job with it. Sometimes they rip you off, but I think they do a good job with it in games like TF2 and such. Games like COD do a terrible job with it. Map packs are incredibly overpriced and are very little content for what it's worth. So, I mean, there's good and bad, but I don't know. I feel we're going to be ripped off by quite a bit in the future. Much more so than we are now. We're ripped off pretty frequently now, even, depending on the game. If you would like to combat these things, do not give Blizzard your money, by the way. Only way you can protest is with the almighty dollar. What am I supposed to be doing right now? Not being where I am. I keep thinking I'm doing the Bounty Hunter questline. You know, I have not given Blizzard money for quite a while, actually. I have not subscribed to WoW for a good while. I have yet to play StarCraft 2. It is horrifying. I have yet to do it. My friend bought it for me, like, 2 or 3 Christmases ago. It is still sitting in my caddy, my desk thing. Still haven't played it. Meant to. But even if I did, I won't feel guilty about it because he bought it for me. I didn't actually give them any money. But yeah, that's really the only thing you can do. My recommendation is play independent games. Terraria, really good game. Bastion, really good game. I've not played Minecraft. I think it's independent. It seems pretty damn big already, but I don't think the dude has sold his soul to a major corporation yet. What else is there? I am playing so effectively right now. I'm paying so much attention to what I'm doing. I could honestly just open up Steam and give you a long list, but it's another one. What else have I played? Well, those are the really good ones that I've played lately. World of Goo! That's an old one, but that's a good game. If you like puzzlers that aren't super difficult. Nemro the Pulchritudinous! That means beautiful, by the way. Pulchritudinous. The more you freaking know. Rainbow. Oops. Report to Doctor Who. Get out of my face, yo. You gonna die. Why do I keep changing my key bindings? Are you a bounty hunter? No, you are the same Imperial agent from before. Maybe. I apologize. I'm paying so little attention to what I'm actually doing. I'm pretty much just roboting it at this point. Good heal. Can't wait to be out of here. You do seem to level up a little faster, though. I don't recall being level 5 already. Last time I did this. It's so convenient that they actually come to me. Pew pew lasers. Wow, I did not expect to roll that far. Backpedal. Backpedal. For people that play MMOs and other games in general, just some friendly words of advice. Please bind your keys. Please. Please for me. Your performance will pretty much double, if not triple, just from binding your keys. There's such a huge difference in reaction times. And I did once keybind when I was young, when I was a wee laddie. I clicked, but within, like, I don't know, a couple of months of playing WoW. I played MMOs before WoW, but I didn't keybind, really. At least I don't think I did. I might have. I played the AOC back in the day. Shout out to the AOC players. Which is Dark Age of Camelot for those not familiar with random acronyms from the late 90s. Played a lot of games over the years. What the frick am I doing? Just killing Renegade Evokai, apparently. I've also been up for a little too long, I think, to be doing this. I'm on a hybrid night day schedule thing. It's not gonna work very well. Come work this week. Dur. Yay for Martin Luther King Day. Dur. Retrieve data core, which is farther south, no? Yes. There should be a boss over here, which I'm not gonna be able to solo. The Harvester. Only 3,500 life. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. It's kind of hard to do even when you're like level 8. Not really hard, but it's more RNG than anything. Derp. Why do I not use my opener thingy? I always forget. Random grenade. Yay, sweet. Should be better, yeah. Also, yay for glowies. There's glowies on armor and stuff in this game. Glowies on my rifle already, actually. Yeah, and my armor. Awesome. Nothing better than glowies. Oh, I really want a PvP right now. Just instance. Anything but solo questing. Can I hearth through the Evil Kite work camp? I can. Sweet. Sweet. I feel like I should get a solid state drive just to put Prev's videos on and speed things up a bit. Not that 30 FPS is bad by any means. I mean, this is entirely playable. I've played in a hell of a lot worse than 30 FPS. Wonder what my MS is. Lovely. 48. It's not bad. Go up the hill. I hate invisible walls. Seriously. There we go. I was gonna say, how is that not climbable? Because in PvP, I can show off my uber skills. By which I mean, I can die repeatedly. Especially as a freaking healer. The level 10 healer in a world with level 50s in the same BG. That's not gonna go well. I just picture many backstabs over and over again. And combo. Which, by the way, I just noticed that my entire outfit is matching my chest piece. And they got rid of that. It was in beta, but they got rid of that. Is that back? Doesn't seem to be. Is it just activated by default? Or does my stuff actually match? Well, let's see. I just got gloves. Where are they? Where's my gloves? Are they? Oh, maybe they auto-equipped. They must have auto... I thought I already had gloves. Apparently not. You bounty hunter? You are. Buffs for you, my friend. What does my buff do? 5% crit chance. That's pretty good. I'll take that. I have no quests? Is that possible? Just go back to Carol's Javis, apparently. Whatever.